Hi all. In this video, let's learn about web storage API and some of the interesting facts about session storage and local storage. We'll be learning all the right side and also the topics and also some of the interesting topics related to that. So firstly, why we use web storage API? Because to improve the user experience and improve the page speed. So these are some of the reasons why we use this web storage API. So let's see. Some of the major companies like Paytm and Flipkart also uses these web storage APIs. So for example, if you here you see in the, if you inspect the browser, you'll be getting this. And in the application tab, you can have the local storage, all the things related to the storage. Go to the local storage and session storage as well. So you'll have some data related to the this. If I select on the flights, so let me clear the local storage. Again, if you select the flights, if you see some of the data was stored here. And also if you see, if you observe the session value, if I click on the session, so is login true and some of the user details, email and my user info. When the session expires, KYC is verified or not, mobile number verified or not, email verified or not. So there are some data is stored in the local storage. This is to give an improve the user experience and improve the performance as well. So for example, if you here you see when I click on flights, so there are two more keys added, nearby airport info, non-stop flights. So non-stop flights false, nearby airport info, there are two additional object is there. So if I give some input here, so it will take some more information from us and it will try to store that in the local storage. This is because from the next time, if I come here, it will try to show these data at the first. So it will improve the user experience. So that's the reason main these companies are going to use this local storage and session storage. Coming to the Flipkart, it also maintains the local storage and the session storage. If you see here, the navigation menu data, so what all the navigations have done. So that information has been stored. So from the next time, also the auto suggest history here. So it will also suggest the history based upon my search results. It will be suggesting me what I need. So to give a better user experience, these websites are using the local storage. So fine. Now let's understand some of the interesting facts about the local storage and session storage. So initially we know that as everyone teaches and you may know, these are the local storage and session storage has the same functions like set item, get item, setting an item. This is a key, this is a value. This can be anything, a string or an object. So this would be the syntax like setting an object, getting an object with a key, removing an object. It will remove only that particular key. Clear means it will clear all the local storage. Key of index, it will get the particular index of that item from the local storage. So, and the length. So these are the common methods we have for these local storage API, and the same reflect for the session storage API as well. So not only in this way, you can also give the data to local storage in this way. So usually we use in JavaScript object.property name is equal to some value. So the similar way also you can give the values to the local storage, but it is recommended to give with this set item. So this is one thing. And coming to the next part, like what is the type of this local storage? So type of this local storage is an object. So also type of this session storage is also an object. Also you can use the local storage directly like this, or also you can use window.local storage, also window.session storage. We can use local storage like this, directly with the local storage or window.local storage. We can use in the neither of the way. Fine. So coming back to the here. So if I refresh this, what happens? So even if I refresh this page also, the local storage and session storage still persists there itself. So they won't be removed. The difference between the session storage and the local storage is like, if I remove one or any of the tab, the session storage would be erased. It will be removed. Whereas the local storage, it will not, in the local storage, it won't be the case. Even if you close the tab, even if you close the browser, even if you restart the mission also, the local storage data would be persisted in the browser itself. So only manually we can delete that. So okay, fine. Coming to a question like in a session storage, we discussed that if we close any of the tab, the session storage would be erased. Okay, now I'm closing this tab. So what if I restore the tab? Restore instance, Control Shift T. As this is Windows, I'm trying to click Control Shift Tab. If it is a Mac, Command Shift Tab. If you click that, the tab would restore. So in instance, we have discussed if once we close the tab, the session storage object would be destroyed. Fine. So what if I restore the tab? Now, let's check whether the session storage still persists my data or not. Yes, it still persists my data. This is because the session storage, even we restore the tab, the data is persisted. This happens only with the Chrome and Firefox browsers. This is not the same in the Firefox, like a Safari case. If we restore the tab, the session storage will be stored only for the Chrome and the Firefox browsers, not for the Safari. So you need to understand this is very specific to the browsers. So that is one of the interesting point we need to understand. And coming to the security part. So let's go back here. So we need to understand something like a same origin policy. Okay, for example, I store something in this object. I mean, in this website, I have stored some local storage or session storage. Okay, so you can access the session storage, local storage only if you have same protocol. So as we have discussed, same protocol, we need to have same protocol. We need to have same host and we need to have same port number. So only in these cases only you can access the local storages, this storage object in other sites. So for example, if you're trying to store some of the information of this website, so can we access that in this? Yes, we can access that because it belongs to the same origin. Means it has the same protocol instance HTTPS and HTTP, only HTTP. So here in this case, we can't access the object, web storage object, because the protocol is different. We have stored the data in HTTPS, suresh.medium.com, but we are trying to access them in HTTP. So it is a different protocol. The stored protocol is HTTPS and we are trying to access it in HTTPS. So we can't access the storage object here. We can't access that. So coming to this is a different domain. So here the domain is suresh.medium, but here we are using blog.suresh.medium. So this is different domain. So here also the storage object can't be accessed. So here the port is different. So these are the reasons. Here also you can't access the storage object. So these are the three storage objects we can't access. So if it is belongs to the same prototype like HTTPS and same domain and same port number, then only you can access the local storage. So I will show this with an example. So for example, and also there is one more point, like if you see this is one website. I'm trying to change some values. And as on when I change, you can observe the local storage is modifying. If I select Firefox or a Crocodile like this, here you can observe the local storage is modifying. So this is the parent page, okay? So this is another page with event.html. If you observe it has this domain protocol, domain, and it has the same thing like the other. So that's the reason this page has access to the same local storage. If you observe here, the background color, font, and image are this. And if you go back here, those are the same. If I modify here something like I will modify to this some blue color. If you go here, it would be modified. Here also it would be modified, the color. The point which I'm trying to make clear is, if you're under same policy origin, you can use the same local storage here as well in the child page as well. So this is only for the local storage. Whereas coming the same example for the session storage, we can't use that. Each session storage is very independent to that tab. If it follows the same origin policy as well. So this is of same origin policy. This is also same origin policy as well. It creates a new session object to this one and this one. Both the session objects would be different. But whereas the local storage, this local storage can be accessed in the same origin policy as well. So that's the main point I'm trying to clear here. So one more point we need to understand here is, so if I store something in one of the browsers like Firefox, so this is browser vendor. Any of the storage, I'm storing some information in the local storage here. This information can't be read by the Firefox or IE. So other browsers can't access these browsers' local storage. This is independent to the browser vendor. Each and every browser storage object is independent to each other. It's not the same as we know. So coming to the when to use this session storage and when not to use this session storage. So session storage and local storage we can use for to make the user experience better and improve the performance. But we should not store the sensitive information like credit card information, access token, passwords, API keys. So all these are the sensitive information. We should not and never need to store them in the storage objects. So that we need to think. So because if we store them in the session objects, then there may be high chances for the cross-scripting attack and they can access these data. So only you need to store and non-sensitive data in here in, by using these local storage and the session storage. Okay, coming to a last example here. So we have an object. So just wanted to explain how the, if you want to store an object in the local storage, directly if you store like this, this is an incorrect way. Everyone used to do the same. As we discussed, we can store a string, any type of data. So that's the reason everyone used to store an object directly like this. So when you store an object directly like this, when you're trying to get an object, it would be get in this format, object.object. So that's the reason you need to store an object like this. You need to stringify an object before storing that object, and you need to parse the object. Yeah, while you are getting that element, you need to JSON.parse that object. So just wanted to explain the correct way of using JSON stringify. While storing the any information object, you need to use JSON stringify. While you are getting that object, you need to use JSON parse. These things you need to remember. So hope you understand this. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to the channel.